I am coming from, I'm going to read from the NLT, the first book of John, coming from John chapter 1. Amen. It says, in the beginning, the Word already existed. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He existed in the beginning with God. God created everything through him, and nothing was created except through him. The Word gave life to everything that was created, and his life brought light to everyone. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never extinguish it. God sent a man, John the Baptist, to tell about the light so that everyone might believe. Say, only believe. Because of his testimony, John himself was not the light. He was simply a witness to tell about the light. The one who is the true light, who gives light to everyone who was coming into the world. He came into the very world he created, but the world didn't recognize him. He came to his own people, and even they rejected him. But to all who believe, say only believe, him and accepted him, he gave the right to become children of God. They are reborn not with a physical birth resulting from human passions or plan, but a birth that comes from God. So the Word became human, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that came in the flesh and made his home among us. He was full of unveiling love and faithfulness, and we have seen his glory and the glory of the Father, one and only Son. So John testified about him when he shouted to the crowds, this is the one I was talking about when I said, someone is coming after me who is far greater than I am, for he existed long before me. From his abundance, we have all received one gracious blessing after another. For the law has given through Moses, but God's unveiling love and faithfulness came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but the unique one, who is himself God, is near to the Father's heart. He has revealed unto us. Right here at this text, when it says that Jesus Christ is the living Word, you're going to have to make your mind up by faith, because it says he is the creator of everything. And when you go and connect this with the beginning, from the beginning of time, God created everything by his word. He believed within himself. And so therefore, since he's within you, you need to believe him that is within. I'm going to try to take my time because I want you to get this. Because we speak of believing, we have to remove the doubt out. You got to get the doubt out. We serve a God that can do everything but fail. So I want to give practical, what is it that you are believing God for? What is it that you're believing God for? And he's speaking to us this morning, and he's saying, only believe. Could we go over to, we can put the, from Mark chapter 5. Look at verse 34. I'm not, for the sake of time, Mark chapter 5. We come in on a story where Jesus heals Jairus' daughter, and she's raised. And we see that Jesus says something here, starting at verse 34. He says, and he said unto her, daughter, thy faith has made thee whole. Go in peace and be whole of thy plague. Look at her. He says, what made her whole? Did he say, I made you whole? He says, your faith. Faith comes by what? hearing and hearing the word of God. And so we know that we have to have the faith of God so that we can believe in God. And then it says, verse 35, while he yet spoke, there came from the ruler of the synagogues, house certain, which said, thy daughter is dead. Why troublest thou the master any farther? And soon as Jesus heard the word that was spoken, he said unto the ruler of the synagogue, be not afraid, only believe. Now look at there. He had just got through doing one miracle, and then here it was, he was coming up on another one. So what is about your situation that you think God can't do? Just like God can work on Sister Shanika's situation at the same time he's working on my situation. God can work on the Green situation at the same time he work on the Harrison situation, because he's God. He's omnipresent. So in order for us to believe, we're going to have to get unbelief out the way. Hallelujah. We got to get the doubt out and what? Only believe. We got to get fear out and only believe. We got to get complaining out and only believe. We got to get strife out and only believe. Starve out doubt and feed faith. Starve out fear and feed faith. Mother Crawford tracking with me. I got my help. I knew I got the Holy Ghost, but I got some help in the room. Amen. Hallelujah. Because God wants to do, God wants to do something for you right now. He said next week, he said he want to do something for you right now. If you would only believe. So the word of God also teaches us, when we're talking about this realm of faith, of walking in, the Bible says the just shall live by. So now the question is, to see if you are a candidate, is, are you the just? Depending on how you answer that question is whether you can keep going on with God. The just shall live by faith. So are you the just? So then therefore, now you're going to have to live by faith. Are you, we just read what Jesus said, that you, when you believe, you are what? A child of God. So regardless of what family you was born in, because you believe that Jesus Christ is the living Son of God, you are now a child of God. So now you're in a different family. And in this family, as a child of God, everything is done by faith. When the daddy speaks, if your natural daddy was messed up and your natural mom was messed up, and then God puts you in the family of God and he gives you a new father, which is the father of the fathers. So when that father speaks, why is it so hard for you to believe? Your natural father may have lied to you. But God says, I am your father. This father created the whole entire universe. This father even created Satan. So therefore, Satan cannot be above him. He's beneath God. So when your father speaks and he tells you to believe and come to me by faith, now, most of you hear me talk about my father, and one thing about my father, he's not a religious man, you hear me say that. Even when he wasn't raised up in the word of God and all of that, but my father's the type of man, if he told you something, he was going to keep his word, or he wouldn't tell it to you. Okay? So even in that even I had that within me, I grew up with that, but it was still something much more when I came into the kingdom of God, and I had this other father, which is God, our Father, we saw in heaven, how will be thy name, thy kingdom come. My natural father could not cause a kingdom to come. My natural father could not forgive transgressions and iniquities. That's a different type of father that is now asking me and saying to me, whether you see me or not, all you have to do is believe. I'm going to say that again. Whether you see me or not, all you have to do is believe. Even if two or three of you come together in my name, I am even have my son to be there in the midst. So even while you speak in faith, he hears it. So now it brings us to the point, what are we speaking? What are we speaking? Because in order for me to believe something, I have to speak that which I believe. I'm getting ready to hit you with something. God's ultimate name is I Am. I'm going somewhere with this. And we sort of sometimes look over that because we always got the I just for us, instead of being more concerned about the I Am. He wants you to get acquainted with I Am, and knowing that when you say I Am, it is the supreme God of the entire universe. So when I Am spoke and said the world is in existence, did it not come about? When he spoke, when I Am said, let there be light, did there not become light? When I Am spoken, he says, let there be a moon and a sun and a stars, did it not come and be exist? And then now you have accepted Jesus Christ, your Lord and Savior. Now that you are a son of God, and now God says that you're to live by faith, and he says, let me just give you this. All you need to do is say, I am healed. I am delivered. I am prosperous. So if I Am spoke and created the entire universe, how much more when you speak that I Am, what should manifest? I'm going to use Minister Smith for this. Come, Minister Smith. Somebody, Dante, get me two chairs. You come bring two, pull these two chairs out here. She doesn't even know what I'm getting ready to do because I want it to be what they call a placebo effect. I don't want her to know anything about what I'm getting ready to do. We're going to put it right here. Oh, yes, I have like 3 degrees. But I'm still from the Poker Bean Prize of Miami, Florida. Hallelujah. I like to tell people that. It keeps me humble. Hallelujah. So the only reason why I chose Minister Smith, first of all, she's up here and she's a woman of faith. She's been around me long enough that she knows how I am and the track with me in the spirit. So Minister Smith, how you doing today? Can we give her a mic?
I'm doing fine, Prophetess. I'm blessed.
You know, I just had such a wonderful, wonderful time and so things that is going so well. You know, over at the, you know, at the church, you know, I was just, you know, I remember a time when Dale was in a wheelchair, you know, and I remember a time when Danielle was single, and I was just thanking God for all these things. And I remember, you know, a time when Amanda didn't have a car to drive, you know, and I was just praising God for all these things that I was just, you know, remembering. And I remember where I used to be 200 pounds. You know, I was just remembering those things. Now, what was going through y'all head when I said, I remember? Okay. For me to say that I remember, it means that it came to pass. But let's be honest, wasn't your flesh and your mind fighting against what was being said? Because I'm trying to take you to a deeper level. Yes. It's one thing when you say, I am healed, and you're not healed. We done arose, to that. We can get with that and still have doubt because it's just a religious thing to say. Because y'all know I'm in prophet's presence, and you know I know she's going to correct me if I say I'm sick. But it's going to take your conscious and unconscious state to really, really, really get with you when I was saying. So when I was saying these things, what was going through your mind?
Going through my mind is I agree. I remember that too. Because I was right there with you. I've been tracking with you, so I can't help but to remember it. And now I see him walking. It is a wonderful to see Danielle with that beautiful diamond on her hand and that beautiful husband of hers living in that new house. And Deacon Dale walking around with his wife dancing. Hallelujah.
Now, you can. I'm being very practical with you. You can do this. Do we have some stickies? Any stickies in the office? You can do. Let AJ, he like to run. Let AJ go find those stickies. Stickies in her office. Is in the drawer, you can find it, right on the shelf. So the reason why I chose Ministry Fam, listen, remember I said, he says the just shall live by faith? I chose Ministry Fam because I know she's a woman of faith. I know if I came up with a bandage on my head and it had blood on there, and she asked me how I'm doing, and I said, I'm doing great. She's a woman of faith to know that I'm speaking faith, and she's a faith enough, and she gonna follow with me. Okay? Let me see if this is going to stick here. Okay, yep, I'm going to use that. Give me about 10 people. Come raise your hand if you want those spontaneous people. Come on, run up here so I don't have to come off the camera. I'm going to tell you what you're going to write. Let me get some males. Don't give me all these women coming up here. Y'all stepping up. Y'all gonna have to step up. Glory be to God. Okay. Come on, I got some more people. Come on. I ain't gonna make you get up and do it. You can go back to your desk. You can go back. I'm gonna tell you what, give you an instruction. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. We can have more than that. Hallelujah. You can sit right there if you want to. Hallelujah. I can get a little one. I'm gonna give you a statement that you're gonna need to make. Amen. So are you guys following me? Call forth those things that be not as though they are. It's in the word. We hear it said all the time. Call forth those things that be not as though they are. We know that. But I'm taking you somewhere deep. I'm giving you a revelation nugget. This is where your faith should grow. You used to say, I'm sick. Then it was, I'm being healed. Then it is, I am healed. Because I just gave you revelation on I am. Not I'm going to be healed. That takes God out of it. I think I'm going to get it. Ain't no God in that. He can't even get in on that. The angels only are activated by his word. If I says, I think I'm going to be healed versus I am healed, which one you think the angel is going to move on?
I am healed.
It's going to be like God just spoke. But now I'm taking you somewhere deeper. Because we don't got this naming and claiming in the body of Christ, and I want to break that. This is going to cause you to have to really use your faith. Because I just said, and here's what you don't understand about, remember I got a master in social work, so I'm giving you some therapeutic stuff with the unconscious and subconscious and all that. Just take it. You ain't got to get the degree for it. Amen. God told me to take my degree and use it for the kingdom of God.
Amen.
When I was speaking to Minister Smith, when I was saying, I remember when, unconscious to her, she was painting a picture in her head of her seeing all of that. So now she is creating. Not only am I creating it, I have now another individual creating it. Deacon Harris. Deacon Harris said, why she probably didn't have this revelation when I had to wait through that 7-year period. Deacon Harris, you might have went around, if he knew this right here back then, and when he met somebody and they knew he was out of work and he was on one of them jobs, he just hated being on that job. And instead of, if Deacon Harris might have said, I'm just ad-libbing this year, I might have met him and say, hey, man, you say, man, I'm looking for a better job. Because, you know, that job I'm on is this, I'm believing God for another job. There's nothing wrong with that statement, right? Because that means we're going to still come in agreement and pray. But I'm getting ready to mess the devil all up. You get ready to mess the devil all up. But if we and Deacon Harris came and said to me, I just love the job that I'm on. It's just a great job. I'm just great in possibilities that's on that job. He has just painted a picture in me that he loves his job. I'm going to walk away from that conversation thinking that Deacon Harris got the best job ever. But when I see, so then when Deacon Harris gets the job, even though it was a year later, I'm not going to think anything different because whether Deacon Harris seen me or not, I've been toiling in my mind this good job that Deacon Harris loves. Now I'm going to take you to, I remember when I did not have a good job. In order for you to say, I remember when I did not have a good job, God has to move in the atmosphere and the universe because you're saying you remember when. Therefore, you're no longer here on the bad job. God has already taken you over here to the job that you're supposed to have. You got to remember because what? I don't like saying this, but in other words, say you got a little G inside of you. We're talking about faith. What I'm speaking right now, probably the average Christian won't even be able to get. And I say, God, this is real deep. He says, did I not say that I spoke in parables because those that was not for me, they would not be able to get it and understand it? He says, so now in the millennium age, I am speaking prophetically. I'm giving revelation and mysteries that are unknown. No, you don't have to have a psychology degree. You don't know about science. You don't know about time. But God said, because you are created in my image, and when you speak it, to call forth those things that be not as though they are. So I am standing here. So I gave everybody to have a paper. Thank you, son. You want to add something to this? What I seen you back there just pulling on my gift.
If I had known that, I would have spoke a lot of things differently 7 years ago. Amen.
We all. And listen, he just gave it to me this week. Because he's taking us, what, in another time. God keeps talking to me about 2020. He's trying to speed some things up. Amen. And this is what's going to cause it to get speeded up. Amen. So now, are y'all fine? Those of you that have a paper, we're going to work this for 30 days. Now, the Bible says God is no respecter of person. And many times, whether you're a babe or whether you think you don't have faith, if you will believe for things of God, you will be able to activate your faith. You will see your faith work. Okay? People go from not knowing God, trying to work in faith. So the best way to be able to get your faith working is start believing for kingdom things. Okay? So I want you to write a statement as I remember when statement that will correlate to Glory Bible Fellowship International Church. Who, when the first one have it, you bring it up here, and I'm going to put it up here. I remember when. Oh, you want a sticker? Come on. I'm not going to bite. Even though you ran off on me for the weekend over to the Sanders. He talking about they some love and care. People said, what you trying to say about me? I've been good on my fast. I have been good. He talking about okay, I remember when GBFRC property wasn't debt-free. Y'all getting this? Okay, come on, somebody bring me another one. I'm gonna read it out because I want everybody to give me a different one. I remember when GBFIC had a mortgage. So what does, see, we got to understand, some of y'all don't went to school now. What does this imply? Come on, bring me another one. Remember, I'm trying to get you to go with kingdom things, because if you can work it for the kingdom of God, it's going to then, when we get ready to try to do, when you try to work it for yourself, amen. I remember when the church was, I don't know if I want to put this one up here. I ain't working with this one. Now I'm not saying that one. Somebody just, you, where we was at, where we gonna be at? We not, now see, this is a good point. You can't say this because it will come to pass. This is what she put. I remember when the church was at Lee Summit. Where we going? But you can, but see, this is the reason why I'm doing this. So you have to have something else added to this. Say that, D, what you saying? Okay. So you guys getting this? This is the reason why I'm doing this, being very practical. Okay? I remember when GBFIC had empty seats on Sunday morning. Hallelujah. I remember when GBFIC Next Glory was not finished. That is, we have a section upstairs that we'll believe in God, amen, to get finished. That is all going to be a children's ministry, a whole children and youth department upstairs. Oops. I remember when GBFIC was having only two buses. I remember when pastor didn't have a consistent salary. Hallelujah. I remember when we all believed God for our debt freedom and we all repurposed our finances for the kingdom. I remember GBFIC had a small congregation. I remember when GBFIC was waiting for 300 Gideons and TLC believers. Hallelujah. That is a promise that we have there. I ain't gonna mess around with you.
You want to read it for you? I'll read it for you.
Oh, okay, it's a good one.
I remember when GBFIC members didn't have millions and foreigns.
Is that everybody? So this, okay. So remember, now let's go back with faith. The just shall live by faith. I am. I remember when we had GBFIC had only a small praise team. I hope you're ready for that work. So are y'all, is it crystal clear or clear as mud? I mean, I told you when I started this morning that I was going to be very practical. When you leave out of here today, you're going to work this. I know you feel like you're in college or somewhere, but you can't. Those of you, that's why some people avoid calling me. Amanda, how many, if you call me on the phone, what you leave back with? Homework. You get on the phone with me, I'm going to give you some scriptures, some stuff that you're going to have to do. Amen. I just don't get on the telephone just to be talking. Amen. Glory be to God. So, everyone understand. So, you're going to use your I am statements. So, for instance, I am healed. But then you're going to say, I remember, and you're going to do this. You can do this with your husband because you've been in this. Don't try to go do this at work because they're going to look at you like you're crazy. But you're going to say, I remember when I was the CEO of this company. Girl, she trying to get the boss lady job. You can do that with another faith believer. And you don't have to as well, okay? But this is so, because what is happening in The realm that you do not see is that God is creating that. For instance, if I would have knew this back then, for instance, I could have passed, and we did to a certain degree, but not to this level, is that Pastor Adam and I came and it was nothing here. We literally was doing this, but we didn't have a name for it. Because when we walked in here, it was empty. But we had a vision that was being created in the inside what should be here. We seen chairs. So therefore, that was becoming to fruition in our mind. But now God is taking it to a level. For instance, upstairs, and after service, some people got to go put some stuff up there. When they walk up there to the next glory, they can stand there when they go up there, you teenagers, because that's who's going to go and take that stuff back up there. Amen. You're going to stand there and say, I remember when this was nothing at all. I remember when we had an old camera, which implies to God that you have now taken yourself from that which you did not have to a state of that which you do have. I remember when I used to have a car note. I remember when I used to have a mortgage. I remember when the test scores over my school were so low. Somebody said, I remember when I had altars. Hallelujah. Are you getting this? My brother-in-law said, I remember when I did not have children. Which implies what? That he has children. Carfoot says it's a whole different level that God wanted to separate from the religiosity about the name it and claim it. And everything in your being is going to try to fight you against this. But you're going to be able, because you're around faith believers, they're going to be able to understand that. Kiara, we said, I remember when I didn't work for the church. I need everybody to say this one. I remember when I did not serve. Everybody need to say that one, because we still got some people here ain't doing nothing. That's a good one. That's a genuine statement. I remember when I did not serve. How about I remember when I did not tithe? Hallelujah. I remember when GBFIC had more women than men. Woo, that's a good one. Hallelujah. That goes along with the vision that I had. And I'm a pastor, I do not believe this. I remember when all my spiritual daughters were single. I remember all my spiritual sons were single. Hallelujah. I remember when Adam Gordon Blessed Out II was not preaching. So this is going to be our core. We're going to work on this for the next 30 days. Amen. And when you get practice, here's why I'm doing this. Because if your faith is low, if you learn how to put the kingdom first, hear me, folks. If you learn how to put the kingdom first, you will see God move for you. But we try to get things from God that's not going to benefit God. God ain't going to give you certain things that he know going to be taken away from you. That's going to take you away from him. Let me say that. I'm going to say that again. There's certain things God is not going to give you because he know it will take you away from him. So one of the ways to get that mentality out of your system is to stop believing for kingdom things. Amen. You are a believer at Glory Bible Fellowship International Church, functioning on behalf of God for the kingdom of God. Everything up here is not because I need it for myself. I am getting the buses for God. We are getting the mortgage debt-free for God. We're getting husbands for our spiritual daughters because we don't want them to keep sinning for God. Not that all of them are. Amen. But the Bible says better to marry than to burn. That's one thing the old folks had it down. Down now we go 13, 14, 15. I wish that would come back right now. Silas, you can't stop fornicating. You want her? Go right ahead. Because I'm so sick of this spirit of perversion. I remember when people got married first before they had sex. I remember when men respected our daughters. We're going to bring back some things from the times of old. Hallelujah. We may think that it's old fashioned, but it's time for it to come back. In the name of Jesus. Some of y'all single, if you haven't seen the movie Old Fashioned, you need to watch it. Some of you single people have not watched that movie. Go watch it. Called Old Fashioned. Be a good thing for you to do on a Sunday. Hallelujah. Say only believe. Handalo, stand to your feet. Karabo she karialaba shedilabaha. Ianderobo she karama she karabama. Kiaramba shalabaha korribe she karama shalaba. Tikandalobo she karababa she talaba. Warababa she karalaba. Ianderobo, Father, we just thank you. We thank you. We thank you for experiencing the spirit of revelation. Some of you don't know if that's what you experienced, was experiencing the spirit of revelation that was released in the room. We ask for all 9 gifts of the spirit to be activated and in function. And one of those 9 gifts of the spirit is faith. I feel a freedom in the atmosphere. I feel your mind being declouded in the name of Jesus. That you will know that God is on your side. Say, I believe. I believe God.